Hi guys, welcome back to Sunday Chat. We have the rest of the Clem Clan this week. A couple weeks ago we had Christy. She did a fantastic job. She was not camera shy. Matt, I can see you shaking right now, brother.
We just worked out.
I'm exhausted. So guys, tell us how you came to CrossFit. Obviously, Josh, the amazing Josh Clem, had something to do with this. Tell us about your journey to CrossFit. Who wants to take it first?
She did it.
It was the amazing Josh Clem.
That led the way.
Very informative.
Led the way. Yeah.
Now, were you resistant at first? Was CrossFit like, I'm scared of that, or?
No, we weren't scared. We were scared of Josh.
You're scared of Josh? Why?
Okay.
Talk, Maddie.
I don't know. My journey has just stopped being a waste of life. The past couple years, ever since I quit rugby, got a little fat and out of shape. It was just Josh's quickest way to me getting back in shape.
Cool. He sold you pretty hard. We were just talking a little earlier about how you do in paleo and zone. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, he started me off on that about mid-February. And I did that for about 2.5 months before I moved back home from school. Went from 245 to 215, lost 30 pounds in 2.5 months from that diet. I was kind of doing P90X on and off my own, but a little motivation to work out by yourself in your apartment. It's kind of a lonely thing to do.
Yeah.
Since I've come here, started hitting the wads, feeling great.
Yeah.
Still doing the paleo, but stopped the zone part of it.
Still eating clean. There's a lot to be said about that. How about you, Dar? Are you eating clean?
No.
Well,
I eat pretty clean for the most part, yeah.
What could we do to get you to do the whole paleo challenge this week? This starting tomorrow. Well, 2 days ago if people are watching this Sunday.
You could cut out the photo shoot in the bathing suit.
Cut out the photo shoot. Is that all we got to do?
That and allow booze.
That.
Yeah, the alcohol.
Booze is a must.
Well, if we say you could have tequila once a week, would you be okay with it?
No, once a week.
Once a week.
Tequila makes people sin.
Makes people sin. My hands are shaking by it here right now. The video's getting all blurry.
Yeah, makes you sin.
All right, tell me.
I eat pretty clean for the most part.
You're pretty clean.
Anyway.
Josh has been preaching the gospel, saying, you got to eat clean, Ma. You got to do this. You'll feel better.
No, I taught Josh this.
Did you?
Yeah.
Really?
From a young lad.
So you knew about paleo for a long time.
I didn't know it was paleo, no.
You just fell upon it? I invented paleo? Is that what you're trying to say? I invented the paleo diet by accident.
Me
I'm just like...
we go way back.
I'm sharing it with you. I'm sharing it with the world now. Somebody else published a book, though, and they're taking all the money.
So, yeah, you guys kind of owe her some royalties.
That's right.
All right, tell me what's been your favorite part about CrossFit so far.
Oh, my gosh, it's so much fun. It's just so much fun. Everybody's always in such a good mood, and you just push yourself beyond what you could possibly imagine you could do. It's incredible. You go home thinking, I just can't believe I just did all that. And you're sweaty, and you're exhausted, and it just feels great. It's so hard to describe. It's like some sick, twisted, fun, crazy kind of energy going on over here.
That might have been the best, single-handedly the best description I've ever heard. Matt, you want to try to top that?
Pretty solid. I think she got it all.
She got it all, just fun?
Pushing yourself farther than you ever have. You know, it's definitely different than just going to the gym and pushing weights around. It's definitely the hardest I've ever worked out.
Now, you said you're from a rugby background.
Yeah.
How does this compare to that?
It's definitely a lot harder.
Yeah.
I mean, in rugby, we would just kind of do sprints running separate from weightlifting. And this is definitely more all-inclusive. Definitely kicks my ass hard. Even though, you know, I mean, I'm definitely more sore after a rugby game, but the endurance and stamina-wise, it's definitely way more intensive than a rugby game.
Mm. Let's finish off with this. Tell us some goals and what you're looking to get out of CrossFit moving forward.
Well, Dean said we had to pick a goal for 2012, so my goal is to flatten my tummy, and Murph tells me that I will get a nice ass irregardless that was going to be my goal, but he said that just comes with CrossFit, so not to worry about it.
That's the reason why I got into CrossFit. I showed up to a competition. I saw some good-looking butts, by the way.
Mine will be there.
There we go.
And so that's my goal.
I like that. I like that a lot. How about you, Matt?
Muscle-ups right now are my enemy, and eventually, the same six-pack.
There you go.
Look sexy on the beach.
Any goals at competing at all?
I won't be a competition. I'm a fat person, I should say.
What about one day? Hey, you lost 30 pounds,
eventually,
man.
That's right.
Eventually.
Eventually. Didn't give any, you give any thought to the competition?
I am a very competitive person. So that is one of the things that's frustrating at CrossFit is coming in and not automatically being good.
Well, it is a humbling experience, but that's what's cool about it. You guys have been fantastic so far. Leave us with some final thoughts. Anything you just want to share with the world?
I'm interested in what your final thoughts are.
I'm glad to share my final thoughts after you, dear.
I think I left it on the table there.
That was emotionally...
by football rules.
I got nothing.
So awkward.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
We love you.